CGT. Okay, thank you. I'm going to start in 10 seconds. Good evening, all the participants who are all attending this particular training program, training of farmers and entrepreneurs under Agribusiness Incubation Center, IIT Kharagpur. In continuation to the yesterday's session on agricultural implements and equipment, I am continuing the same session today also. Yesterday we have seen about till puddling implements. There we have seen the full cage bill and half cage bill. The wetland operation also we have seen. From here onwards, I'm just continuing. As we have observed, the sowing equipment for mentioning for the different crops, what is the seed rate required, what is the row spacing is required, and what is the plant density, I have just tabulated over here in this particular slide for sowing the these crops. If you see the paddy, seed rate is between 60 to 80 kg per hectare. The bulk density of this one is 500 to 650 kg per meter cube. Here once again I'm mentioning the technical names like seed rate. What is the weight of a seed is required to cultivate 1 hectare of crop? That is the seed rate. Bulk density. The bulk density is the if you consider certain volume of 1 meter cube or 1 liter or any volume, what is the weight of seed that can be accommodated into that as a bulk? That is the bulk density. And number of seeds per kg, how many are there in 1 kilo seed? How many seeds are there? What is the row spacing we have to maintain for a particular crop in centimeter? And what is the plant to plant spacing we have to maintain? That is in centimeter. And depth of sowing, how much depth I need to sow, and number of seeds per meter square. Suppose if I'm sowing per meter square, how many seeds or plants should be there? This is the thing. And optimum plant population also, it is indicated over here per meter square, how many plants should be there as a plant population is also indicated here itself. If you observe for paddy, the seed rate is 60 to 80 kilo per 1 hectare is required. Most of the farmers, they will be going in terms of bag. Here I have indicated in terms of the kilo. 1 hectare requires 60 to 80 kg. The bulk density is 500 to 650. It depends on the variety, but as a overall, I have mentioned the value over here. And number of seeds per kilogram, it is 25,000 to 30,000 into 1,000 will be there per 1 kilo. And row spacing we have to maintain 20 centimeter per paddy, and plant to plant spacing is 2 to 3 centimeter, and depth of sowing is 3 to 5 centimeter, and number of seeds per meter square, if we just spread onto that, it will be 150 to 280 seeds will be there per meter square. It is in the nursery. Then after that, once we plant that one for the population, there we can get 75 to 150 plants per meter square. Why this data is required for us as a farmer, reason is that I want to purchase a seed, but how much seed is required to cultivate whatever the land I have. For that, this particular parameter, seed rate is very important. Then bulk density. Suppose I got the seed, we have to store it. For storing, how much space is required? As a farmer, it is required. And for as a machine, suppose I have a seed box, they will be giving in terms of volume in meter cube. Means I need to fill at a time this much amount of seed in the any, suppose if it is not for paddy, for any dry land sowing operation, I can know based on the volume how much weight of seed I can able to pour. That we can get an idea from this particular parameter. number of seeds per kg means if I purchase 1 kilo, how many seeds will be there? It is very important for some of the crops, like where we have to maintain plant to plant spacing and row to row spacing. Based on this one, we can able to get how many plants we can able to get from 1 kilo, and directly we are getting in the number. Even there is a certain germination percentage and all, if we consider that, we can able to get how many population or plants we can get per unit area if we go with the this particular seed rate. The next parameter is row spacing. Yes, row spacing means we are just planting for paddy. We are going under a transplanting operation. There we are going with the row to row, means there are different rows. If we go as a mechanical transplanting, here between two rows we have to maintain 20 centimeter distance, and between plant to plant 2 to 3 centimeter. Anyway, the machine is doing, but we have to go with this particular specification. Even in the machine also, there are different settings for row to row spacing or plant to plant spacing. Some machines are coming with the plant to plant spacing. There we can able to adjust how much is required based on the variety. Anyway, as a machinery point of view, I am giving these values. Again, we can consult with agronomist, and based on variety also, these parameters slightly will change the values. Now the depth of sowing, as I have indicated, 3 to 5 centimeter per paddy, and number of seeds 150. I mentioned it is required that suppose I have to go for a nursery, means how many plants per meter square I can able to get, and optimum population in the field also will be there. Based on that, we can able to predict the yield after during the harvesting, how much yield I can get. Based on this population also, we can able to get. And the yield is also very important parameter that depends on. If we make the plants very dense, then there is a competition between the plants. And if we go with the plants with more space, then there is again a change in the yield. There is an optimum value they have mentioned. If we go with this particular population of the plants, we can get the maximum yield. It depends on the maximum yield. For wheat also, the seed rate is 70 to 120 kg, bulk density is 768 to 797 kg per meter cube. Number of seeds we can get per kilogram as 18 to 24,000. Row spacing is 15 to 22.5 centimeter, and plant spacing we can get 3 to 5 centimeter for the wheat crop. And the depth of sowing is 5 to 6 centimeter, and number of seeds 160 to 240 per meter square. And after growing the population in the field, we can get the optimum plant population is 100 to 160 plants per meter square. The another important crop is cotton. For cotton, the seed rate is 10 to 12 kg per hectare. Bulk density is 400 kg per meter cube. Number of seeds, 1 kilogram we can get 8 to 10,000. And row spacing is 50 to 80 centimeter row spacing, plant spacing 20 to 40 centimeter. Here as a planter we are using, we are to maintain row to row spacing as well as the plant to plant spacing for the cotton crop. See, you can observe here the spacing is more between the plants also. And depth of sowing 3 to 6 centimeter as a seed we are sowing. And the number of seeds per meter square area 8 to 12. That means for each location as a planter, we will be going as a twice, but optimum population we will be getting 5 to 7 after growing that. This is the best population for getting the maximum yield. Now sunflower crop, again the seed rate is in the range for 10 to 15 kg per hectare. Bulk density is 409 kg per meter cube. Number of seeds per kilogram we can get 23 to 25,000. Row spacing is 45 to 80 centimeter. Plant to plant spacing 20 centimeter for sunflower crop also. And depth of sowing almost 3 to 5 only we are maintaining for most of the crops except for the wheat, the depth of sowing. And number of seeds per meter square is 20 to 25 seeds per meter square. And optimum plant population we have to maintain at 10 to 15 plants per meter square. Another crop I have taken as maize. For this also, the seed rate 15 to 20 kg per hectare, bulk density 718 kg per meter cube, and number of seeds we can get 5 to 6,000 seeds in 1 kilogram of weight. and row spacing is 45 to 60 centimeter, plant to plant spacing at 20 to 25 centimeter, and the depth of sowing 3 to 5 centimeter, and number of seeds we can get 7 to 12, and optimum population we are getting 6 to 7. See here also at one location is almost that twice we are planting, and once it grows we can get 6 to 7 plants per meter square area. Groundnut, yes, here also we have seed rate 100 to 130 kg per hectare. Bulk density is 640 kilogram per meter cube. And number of seeds per kg is 2500 to 3000 per groundnut. And row spacing 25 to 30, 2.5 is given, 22 to 30 row spacing we can maintain. And plant to plant spacing is 5 to 10 centimeter. And depth of sowing we can sow the same range of 3 to 5 centimeter. And number of seeds per meter square are 25 to 39. And the optimum population for maximum yield 16 to 22. That means the groundnut, if we consider it per meter square, we'll be getting an optimum population of 16 to 22. And you can also observe that the row spacing is also 22 to 30 centimeters. And soybean crop seed rate is 80 to 100 kilogram per hectare. Bulk density is 19 kg per meter cube. Number of seeds per kg 5 to 8 thousand. We can get seeds per kilogram. Row spacing is 20 to 45, and plant to plant spacing is 5 to 7 centimeter, and depth of sowing is 3 to 5 centimeter. Number of seeds per meter square is 30 to 64 seeds per meter square. And optimum plant population we can get 25 to 40 in number of plants per meter square. And this optimum plant population, plant to plant spacing, that is row spacing, and plant to plant spacing, these are all dependent. We can achieve this particular value if we go with the required row spacing and plant to plant spacing and the number of seeds per kg. It will directly we can get with the optimum plant population if we maintain with this particular spacing. That is why these numbers, even though they are looking like as a number, they are very, we have to just keep in mind while cultivating to get the maximum yield. As an agronomist, they have specified for the maximum yield we can go with this particular optimum plant population of some of the important crops. Now we have understood, or we have done the tillage operation, the primary tillage and the secondary tillage operation we have done. We have leveled the field. For sowing, we have the equipment, the seeders we have, planters we have, how much plant to plant spacing, row to row spacing we have to maintain, that also we have seen. We are entering into the cultivation of, or after planting, what are the different operations are there in the field and what all the machines are available for that, we can able to see one by one from now onwards. Normally for paddy cultivation, what we used to do is that directly we can broadcast the seed into the field. And from there, once the nursery grows, after normally 21 days is recommended, then we have to take out the seedlings from there, from the nursery, and we are planting into the field, the other location. The process of planting from one place to the other place means shifting the plant, transferring and planting is called as transplanting. Means we are transplanting the paddy crop. Why we need to do this operation? Even though there are direct methods are also there, there are even the some of machines or equipment are also available. Directly we can go with the paddy seed and put it into the drum seeder and drag it into the wetland after puddling operation. Then we can able to get the population, or we can able to grow the paddy that is there. And sometimes there are the ways that some of the locations the people are directly going with the direct sowing in the dry land, and after that they are giving water. With that also they are going with the direct cultivation. Yes. Now the transplanting operation, the thing is that as a nursery, when the plant is as a kid, it occupies lesser space and we can monitor, and easily we can able to do some of maintenance operations, like we can give water and we can able to protect that one, and whatever the nutrients or the fertilizer is required for that, we can contribute to that. If the area is very less, the maintenance will be very easy. The entire nursery we can grow separately. And that is one thing. The second thing is that by that time we can able to prepare the entire field as a primary tillage, secondary tillage, and water it and go with puddling operation, make it ready. Then after that we can go for the transplanting. The advantage of this transplanting is that we can make the good quality nursery seedlings, and from there we can able to transplant. If I go directly with the direct seeding, I have kept the seed into the field, but I cannot give the guarantee that that can grow or that can germinate into the main field. If it is not germinating, then again I have to go with the replacement of that particular location with a new plant. If it is the nursery, already the plant got germinated, then I can mention that yes, I can able to transplant over there in the location, and I can able to maintain the optimum plant population. That is the advantage with the transplanting operation. Yes, the transplanting operation will also have certain disadvantages, that again it is like two tasks. I have to spread the seed into the field, and after germination, after 21 days, again I have to keep them more manpower to take from one location to the another location, and again there I need to do the operation of like transplanting or sowing, but actually it is transplanting of the seedlings. It is like a repeat action, and more manpower is required. That is why nowadays the farmers, they are preferring a drum seeder in place of the transplanting, even though it is creating some of the problems, like in the field we have to maintain the entire field from sowing, means putting the seed into the field to till its growth. The entire field we have to monitor. The availability of manpower is causing this particular problem. That is why there are, again, the thing is that we have to prepare the nursery, and from there we have to transplant the seedlings to the other location. Nowadays the machines are available for doing this particular operation. Whenever we are going for the mechanical transplanting, we have to maintain in the nursery mats, these are all called, means we have to prepare the nursery also such a way that it can be properly utilized by the machine for transplanting. It should fit to the machine. Because of that, people are just, the farmers, they used to feel that it is a little hectic process. Direct sowing is the best way. This to fit, but nowadays the machines are available. One of that particular machine what I am showing over here is that the nursery seeder. Automatically we can prepare the nursery, rice nursery sowing machine is over here. We can prepare the rice seedlings into the nursery trays, and these trays can be easily handled from one location to the another location, and there these nursery mats into the trays we can directly put to the transplanter. The transplanter can do the operation of transplanting. For mechanical transplanting operation, the nursery mats also should be uniform for having a better transplanting operation. Generally, normally it is a 24 centimeter to 30 centimeter tray widths are available. It is selected based on the width of the mechanical transplanter, how much mat it can able to accommodate. If you observe here, the different power required for sowing motor, transplanting motor, sprinkling the soil funnel volume, the parameters are given over here, and how, what is the efficiency. That means in 1 hour, using this machine, we can able to make a nursery of 600 to 800 trays per hour. And sowing quality we can observe over here is that per tray we can get 65 to 150 gram of paddy seed. Normally, on an average, 3 people are required to make the nursery mats for 40 acres per day. We can operate using this particular machine in an 8-hour of work cycle. Per 8 hour in a day, we can, with that, for 40 acres in one day, we can able to prepare the nursery mats using this particular machine. It was developed by Redland. I'm just showing over here is that. See, we are filling the soil into a particular tray, seed into the another tray, then again soil onto the third tray. Three things are there, not tray. These are all the hoppers. In the first hopper, soil, second offer seed, and third offer like the fertilizer or vermicompost also we can see. Here you can observe the person is feeding the trees one by one, and when it is coming over to the first hopper, it is just releasing the soil and filling uniformly with a certain depth into the tray. Then after that there is a compression, and it is just filling the water. Then we can get the seed is falling uniformly into the second hopper. The third hopper is filling the soil, and at the end there is again a compactor. It is just compacting, and finally we are getting the nursery trays. See, these are all the nursery trays filled with the rice seeds. Then after that, for planting, as per the mechanical, we can go for 12 to 18 days as recommended over here. After that, we can see here, see the plant, plants are grown. The padding nursery is ready for the transplanting operation. As a tray wise, it will be very easy to maintain. Even the entrepreneurs can go into this particular domain where they can able to start their own nursery. And nurseries are also nowadays coming up with good scope, because when the mechanization is there, getting the nursery transplant nurseries or seedlings, it is very important aspect. Thereby we can go with as a small entrepreneurship with the making these nurseries using this machine. This is the paddy seedling nursery making machine, nursery seeder. Next one, I am going with the transplanting operation. Once the nurseries are ready, the paddy seedlings are ready, the mats are ready, we can go with the transplanting operation with the transplanter or transplanting machine. The rice transplanter is there. The rice transplanter was introduced in 1960s in Japan. The rice transplanter is a specialized transplanter fitted to transplant rice seedlings onto the paddy field, as I discussed earlier. Here I have indicated the VSTNG Shakti 8 row paddy transplanter. The cost also I have just mentioned. The approximate cost over here is 2,30,000 with the GST. It is actually the 8 row. This is the location where we can keep the mat seedlings. The entire thing will be powered by an engine. The engine is giving power per movement of the machine as well as for the transplanting operation. We are doing this operation in the wetland operation. That is why we have a float. Float, it will protect the entire machine from submergence. Means the entire machine will not get into the soil, the wet field. It will protect as a float. And the one operator, he can directly sit onto this and he can direct the machine in a straight row. And in the beginning of the operation, we just have to feed the nursery seedlings or mats over here. And there is a mechanism. This mechanism, it is called as a transplanting mechanism. It will pick the seedlings and place into the soil as per the desired depth. The depth of operation also we can able to control here. There is a just below the down of this float. The adjusting mechanism is there based off of the entire the unit. Thereby we can adjust the depth of planting for this. And here in this particular machine, the row to row spacing is fixed. Now you can observe the operation starting with the puddling, and they will be going for the transplanting operation. This is the puddling. We are giving the water, and these are all the nurseries prepared into the field, not as a tray nursery seedlings. These are all prepared in the field itself. They are directly using feeding into the machine. Once the nursery mats are fed into the machine, we can give water for smooth movement of the seedling mat down. You can observe that this mechanism is just picking the seedlings and placing into the puddled field, the wetland operation. And the provision is also given for two operators to sit, and thereby they can able to just monitor the nursery mats. Once it is over, then they can again feed back. This is the rice transplanter. On the road, we can lift the entire thing and we can able to take into the field. But on the wetland, we just have to take out the pneumatic wheel and we have to replace with the cage wheel, the metallic wheel. Here, they have maintained a 23.8 centimeter spacing. For best results, the nursery plot, they are asking to prepare that. Bed height also they have mentioned 2 centimeters is required for preparing the nursery. We should not allow the nursery to dry up. Do not spray urea onto the nursery. And puddling should be very shallow, like 10 to 15 centimeter only we have to just go with. Otherwise the submergence or sinkage of the machine is there. We have to splash the water during the transplanting operation. And we should not leave the nursery to over dry. This is the manual transplanting and this one is the mechanical transplanting. The parameters I have yesterday also have indicated some of the parameters like field capacity. What is this field capacity? And the field capacity is using this machine, what is its capacity in the field? Means how much area it can able to cover. This area is the actual field capacity, whatever I have indicated over here. There is another term is also called as theoretical field capacity. That means I have a machine of 1 meter width and I'm going with 1 meter per second. Then it can able to do 1 meter square area per second. Means area per unit of time I got. But the same machine, whenever it is making turning and all, there is certain loss of time. If I consider the loss of time also into as a factor, that one is called as the actual field capacity. Theoretically, if I'm just moving with the same speed, how much area I can cover without any loss, that is the theoretical field capacity. Actual field capacity means during the turning, there is a wastage of time, but I need to make that for going for the next row. There are turning losses are there. Sometimes whenever the seedlings are over, I have to feed the nursery mats into this. Considering all these factors into account, we can get the actual field capacity. That is important. Why this particular parameter, the field capacity is that using this machine, how much area I can able to cover in 1 hour or per unit of time. Using this field capacity, I can even able to get per hectare, how much fuel I can allow or how much fuel I have to use. Based on that, the cost also we can able to estimate for the particular machine. This machine, it requires the field capacity of this machine is 0.1 hectare per hour. And that means for doing 1 hectare operation, it requires 10 hours time. While doing the planting, the speed is like 0.44 to 0.54 meters per second. The manufacturer has indicated this is in this range, we can able to operate. It is going very slow because it is the transplanting we are doing on a wetland, wet field. That is why the speed is almost, it is less. That is why we are getting the time factor, means more time is required compared to the other dry land operations. Now, on route, we can take this machine at a speed of 8.2 kilometer per hour. And working speed is, as I have indicated, 0.64 kilometer per hour. With that particular speed also, we can able to outdo the operation. This is about the paddy transplanter. We have seen about the paddy transplanting operation. Similarly, we have the transplanters for other vegetable crops also. Now, here I'm showing you the vegetable transplanter. A transplanter is an agricultural machine used for transplanting seedlings to the field. This is very important as it reduces the time taken to transplant seedlings, as I have indicated. When we compare with the manual transplanting, mechanical transplanting takes very less time. And it allows more time for harvesting. It also reduces the use of manual energy. Means the human requirement is also very less. As quickly we can do this operation if I take the assistance of the mechanical transplanters. For this particular machine, actually it was developed at TNA Coimbatore. It is semi-automatic transplanter. At Kharagpur also, we have developed the transplanters, the semi-automatic and the automatic transplanters. Here in the semi-automatic transplanter, the person is sitting over there and is just picking the seedlings and placing it into the metering unit. In the metering unit, it will just go as per the distance traveled, and based on the plant-to-plant spacing, it can able to allow the plant to fall down, and there is a mechanism to open the furrow, and there is a mechanism to close the furrow. Means once you open the furrow, the seedling will be falling over there, then the other mechanism will cover. It is like I am putting the seedling, seedling means the plant, into the soil, and I am covering the soil. Means I am giving as encouragement to the plant to grow into the soil. The mechanisms are also available, fitted all together. That is why all the mechanisms are coupled together to get the under machine. And this machine is again coupled to the tractor. It is the tractor is a power source. For this particular machine, there 33.57 kilowatt of tractor or above power is required. And the working width of this one is like 1.35 meters. Row spacing we can maintain as a 45 centimeter, and the weight of this machine is 350 kg. 45 centimeter means the row to row. Suppose you can observe here, there are different rows are there for the plants. This row to row spacing we can maintain at 45. Depends on the crop variety as I have indicated earlier. Now the performance of these parameters, the field capacity is 0.14 hectares per hour. In 1 hour, I can cover 0.14 hectares. The speed of operation is 1.4 kilometer per hour. And how much force is required to drag this implement or this equipment is 250 kg. I'm just showing the another transplanter in the operation. Here we have the mechanism, the metering mechanism. The people, they are just picking the seedlings and placing into the metering mechanism. And there is a furrow opener, and that will transplant into the field. Even water tank is also kept over there. After planting, even watering also we can able to do in the other machine. You can see this machine, thereby you can able to understand the mechanism. See, this is the mechanism, the two wheels. It is just covering the soil after keeping the plant, and manually is just feeding into the metering unit one by one. It is 7 rows at a time. 7 people are sitting, and for each row they are just feeding. This is semi-automatic type. In the fully automatic type, the intervention or interference of the manpower is not required. Automatically it can able to pick and place the machine. The next one is, after planting, we need to do the intercultural operations. The intercultural operations means like weeding and plant protection. Means after sowing or transplanting till to the harvesting, what are all the operations are there? All these operations are coupled under intercultivation or intercultural operations. What are the intercultural operations? In between, I have to weed and remove the weeds. I have to supply the fertilizer into the field. I have to protect the crop from insects and pests. All these operations are coupled together as a intercultural operations. Here we can see one by one. The first one is the power weeder, weeding operation. The power weeders are designed to ease the task of removing weeds from the garden or from the field crops. These power weeders, it is like a walk behind type. That means the person has to walk behind the weeder. It is very portable machine. You can see here the person is behind the machine. That is why you can able to control. The handle is provided over here. Whenever we need to start the operation of feeding, that time we can just press this particular lever. Thereby the machine is under operation. We can start the engine. Whenever we just press this one, then the operation will be under a motion. Now here we have the engine also, and we have the weeding unit. It is similar to your rotavator, as I have indicated earlier. In the small size, the rotors are there, and the rotors, the blades are mounted. These blades, they'll just mix the soil with the after cutting the weeds. Means they'll just cut the weed and mix into the soil. This is the small unit. You can see Hitachi centrifugal power weeder. I'm showing over here. Its cost is 65,000 rupees approximately with the GST. And the power requirement for this is, the small engine is kept it over here as the engine, and 3 to 5 HP engine is there. And width or row spacing, we can get the entire working width as a 330 centimeter, and depth of operation it can do at a depth of 7 centimeter. Weight of the entire machine is 90 kg. We'll see the operation, then after that I will discuss the performance of this machine. And observe here in the field between two rows, it is doing the weeding operation. In the cotton crop, is doing for the weeding operation using this particular machine. Even the soil also mixed up over here, thereby the plants can get good aeration. The air movement will be there into the soil. Here, if you observe, the field capacity of the machine is 0.22 hectare per hour. For 1 hectare, we may require like 5 hours for doing this operation. And fuel consumption is 0.821 liter per hour, and speed of operation is 2.52 kilometer per hour. Even the same machine also can be used for paddling. For paddling, it is 0.38 hectare per hour. And 3.5 liter per hour to 0.11 hectare per liter. This is the fuel consumption. Means for 1 hour, it consumes 3.5 liter during the wetland operation. Even though it will be useful for the small farmers where the land is very fragmented in small land. Such type of this machine can also be used for wetland puddling operation. Now, after doing the weeding, removing the weeds, whatever I have showed here is that on the mechanical weeding. Yes, nowadays we can even control the weeds with the help of herbicides. The herbicides are like as a spray liquid. We can spray that one onto the weeds. With this weeds, we can able to control, or we can kill these weeds with the herbicides. Here, the spraying equipment I have mentioned. The spraying equipment. As a liquid, we can spray onto the plants for protecting the crop or killing the weeds or killing the insects and pests. Here, the boom sprayer I have showed. The boom sprayer was first automation nozzle was invented by Thomas of Toledo, Ohio. In the late 18,000, he was invented this particular boom sprayer. It is used to apply liquid fertilizers, pesticides, or other liquids to crops during their vegetative cycle. Even the spray liquid as a fertilizer also we can supply to the crops. The specifications given over here are the boom height, means how much height we can able to adjust. Boom means the entire bar. This is the called as boom. On this boom, the nozzles are mounted, nozzles through which we can spray the liquid. Either it may be a pesticide or insecticide or herbicide, we can spray that liquid. Here, this boom we can adjust from the top surface of the crop. The range is given as 50 to 200 centimeter we can adjust. Then real tank, the volume of the tank is given the liters. It is the boom sprayer. Whatever I have showed is John Deere India Private Limited, the boom sprayer. Its cost is 1.35 lakh. They have the boom sprayer. And the spray boom, it is of even we have 12 meter length or 20 meter length is also available. That is why this much big size of tank, like 1 meter cube tank, is also available. And number of sections we can do, or we can mold it as a 5 sections. Each section width is also given. 5 section is each section width is 4 meter. That is why the 20 meters is also available. If it is 3 sections, then it is 12 meters. The total weight of the empty, the entire machine with the empty tank is 1,280 kg, and the total weight with full tank is 2,485, because it is accommodating 1,000 liters. That is why it is also added up over here. You can see the operation of I have taken the video just to indicate that how it will be operated into the field. Yes, you can observe here the entire boom sprayer at a time. See how much width we can able to cover. As a 20 meter at a time we can cover. That is operated into the field for spraying operation. Anyway, this much big size, the land size also should be very big for operating such machines. Even we have the small size boom sprayers are also available in our country. Yes, this is the boom sprayer for protecting the crop from insect pests, and even sometimes to kill the weeds using herbicide. Now we are entering into the harvesting and threshing machinery. Harvesting means cutting the crop from the field, and threshing, separating the grains from the stack. These two operations are there. When we couple these two operations with the cleaning and bagging all together, the entire operations are called as combining. We are combining all the operations. That is why we have the machines also like as a combined harvesters or combined threshers we have. Here, if you observe, for paddy crop, I have just indicated here the manual harvesting, the manpower is required to cut the crop and lay the crop onto the field. Thereby, the crop can get dry, and later on we can use that one for threshing. Even the threshing also, the manual threshing is there. The earlier days, we have the plank on that, we can beat the crop, we can separate the grain. Using the air movement, the people is to clean the grain. Nowadays, with mechanical part, we have the combine harvesters, or we have the mechanical harvesters are also there. We can cut the crop, we can keep the crop side by for sun drying, and later on we can use that one for the threshing operation. Otherwise, directly we can couple the all the operations, like we can cut, thresh, clean the grain and bag it or store it into a overhead tank. All these operations are also are there in the mechanical combine harvesters. Here you can observe that the mechanical threshing, after manual cutting also we can go for the threshing operation. In the threshing operation, the grain will be separated after cleaning, and later the grain can be filled into the bag. This is the mechanical thresher. Here we can see the different machines which are available for harvesting and threshing of the crop. Mostly are covered here. More number of machines related to the paddy cultivation, as our India is the main producer after China for the paddy. You can see here the first machine, whatever I'm showing is that the vertical conveyor or reaper. Here, the vertical conveyor reaper generally is suitable to harvest and windrowing cereals and oil crops. For oil crops, cereals, the vertical conveyor reaper is used. The name has come as vertical conveyor reaper. We can convey the crop in the vertical condition, means from one location to the another location, we can convey the crop. It is having different components. It is also like walk behind a type, the small unit. We have the handle. The operator can stand behind that and he can go forward along the machine. The machine is powered with an engine. The engine is giving power for propelling, means taking the machine from one location to the another location, and for cutting the crop, conveying the crop, and laying the crop side by. Here, for cutting the crop, we have a cutting unit. For conveying the crop, we have the conveyors. These are all the star wheels are there. They will just convey the crop from one location to the other location. Means the entire row, the crop will be collected and it will be allowed to fall side by. This is the vertical conveyor reaper I have showed here. Different vertical conveyor reapers are there as a self-propelled riding type. A vertical conveyor reaper is there. Walk behind type of vertical conveyor reaper is there. And sometimes they are tractor operated. The vertical conveyor reapers are also available. We can directly mount them. Not this machine, the very size is big. Such machines also we can operate with the tractor. I have given the specifications of like self-propelled riding type vertical conveyor reaper, tractor mounted vertical conveyor reaper, and not only the reaping and laying down the crop side by, there are machines are available, even they can bind the crop. That is why these machines are all called as self-propelled reaper cum binder, means we can cut the crop and we can bind the crop together. Both the operations are there in certain machines. The power requirement, 5 horsepower of power requirement is required for self-propelled. 35 HP tractor we can use. The machine cutting width is more. If you go with the self-propelled, it is like 1 meter. And tractor mounted, we have like 1.6 meters to 2 meter. And the self-propelled reaper binder is 1.2 meter width. Machines are available. Their weight also are given over here. And field capacity, if you observe, with self-propelled riding type vertical conveyor reaper, in 1 hour we can cover 0.29 hectares. And that means almost we may require 4 hours to complete 1 hectare. And price is 80,000. Only for this particular machine, it is not with the power. Means we can couple this machine with the tractor later on. Its cost is coming as 45,000 only for the machine that we can couple with our tractor power with PTO. We can able to operate that. And there is a reaper combiner. Its cost is 2 lakh. The approximate cost I have indicated over here. You can see the operation of this one. The manufacturer for this vertical conveyor reaper combiner, Manish Agro Industries in Gujarat. I just got this particular video for this particular reaper binder, and it's for the cost. It is 1,20,000. They have indicated the width is less for this one. You can observe the operation. They are using the for wheat crop. Here, whatever the videos I have showed only for the reference. Video I might have taken from some other company to demonstrate how the machine perform in the machine performs in the field for this particular operation. You can observe it is just collecting the crop and cutting. Then after cutting, the entire crop is as a bunch. It is binding, and after that it is allowing the bundles into the field at different intervals.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, this is machine is not a successful.
Yeah, this machine is not successful. That is why I'm just successful in the sense.
Sir, I have already this use in before 3 years in my field.
Okay.
Yes. This is reason behind is sir. ये सर जो bundle बनाती है ना जो वो धागा होता है.
Yeah.
वो धागा वो सर थ्रेसिंग जब हम करते हैं तो उसमें जाके प्रॉब्लम क्रिएट करता है, बार बार बंद करना पड़ता है हमको.
इन प्रेशर राइट
जी,
ब्रशिंग ऑपरेशन राइट. हेलो
हेलो
या
हाँ सर, मैं ये बोलना चाह रहा हूँ, जैसे ये जो मैं थ्रेसिंग हम करते हैं बाद में लास्ट में इसको बंडल बनने के बाद.
ये चीज सत्येंद्र प्लीज.
यस यस जी
या
तो सर ये जो है ना वो सर थ्रेसिंग में प्रॉब्लम करता है.
यस यस आई नो दैट. डू यू नो व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम इन थ्रेसिंग?
हाँ सर, प्रॉब्लम ये होती है जो मतलब धागा उसका होता है वो लिपट मतलब अंदर जाके थ्रेसिंग में फंस जाता है.
क्यों जान समझे किस लिए हो रहे हैं ऐसे?
उसमें ये था सर, या तो उसको निकाले हम बार बार.
नहीं है,
लेवर
है आपका, मॉइस्चर कंटेंट है. आप बंडल बना के छोड़ दे रहे हैं ना, वो ड्रेन नहीं होता ठीक से.
नहीं नहीं सर, वो ड्राई होता है.
तो इसलिए वो पस जा रहा.
वो सर ये इसमें जो वो जिससे बनता है ना सर, वो
बंडल
डोरी जो, हाँ जी डोरी जो होती है सर.
हाँ हाँ,
वो डोरी जो है हमारे थ्रेसिंग में जाके फंस जाती है.
आप उसके साथ छोड़ दे रहे हैं क्या मशीन में?
हाँ,
मशीन में तो ऐसा नहीं बोलते हैं.
हाँ,
आप उसके साथ छोड़ने के लिए
नहीं, सीधा मशीन में
बोल रहे
हैं
ना अपने.
जी जी सर.
हाँ, रस्सी से कैसे छोड़ेंगे आप मशीन में? तो उसके लिए क्लियरेंस तो है, इधर तो नहीं. आपका थ्रेशर का देखने से उसमें उसको आपको क्रॉप को एक लेयर जैसे वो बना के अंदर बेचते हैं. आप एकदम बंडल बना के दे देने से वो खा नहीं पाएगा ना मशीन थ्रेशर एकदम.
वैसे क्या होता है सर, हमारी लेबर जो है उसको खाली उसी के पुआल से बांधती है जो मतलब ग्रॉस जो भी मतलब हमारी हार्वेस्ट फसल होती है उसी को उससे बांधते हैं हम लोग, तो वो आसानी से वो उसमें थ्रेसिंग हो जाती है थ्रेसर में.
हाँ, वो थ्रेशर का परफॉर्मेंस मैं नहीं बोल रहा हूँ, आप कैसे दे रहे हैं.
जी.
थ्रेशर तो एक मशीन है, उसको आप कैसे दे रहे हैं वो इम्पोर्टेंट है ना. खाने के लिए खाना खिला रहे हैं मशीन को, वो खाने का भी खिलाने का भी एक तरीका होता है ना. आप बंडल बंडल जैसा उसमें मशीन में डालने के लिए कहीं बोला है क्या वो मशीन का मैन्युफैक्चरर आपको ऐसा बंडल में देने के लिए?
नहीं सर, बोला तो नहीं है, बट सर ऐसा ना फिर हम दो तरह से फिर काम करना, लेबर भी एक्स्ट्रा लगाना पड़ेगा ना फिर.
समझ लिया, समझ लिया.
जी सर,
देखिए आपका लेबर का कॉस्ट आप एक बार देखने से आपका लॉस ज्यादा हो रहा है ना. क्रॉप तो उसको ठीक से काम नहीं कर रहे हैं मशीन, आपका क्रॉप का लॉस ज्यादा हो रहा है ना.
इसमें कई सारी बातें आती हैं सर.
हाँ ये
सर, हमारा क्योंकि फसल या तो फिर सही होनी चाहिए सारी.
हाँ, सही होनी चाहिए, काम जल्दी होना चाहिए, मेन थिंग ये है ना. काम तो जल्दी होना चाहिए और
काम बस इससे जल्दी होता है,
उनको भी हम संभालना पड़ेगा. आप चलाइए इसको बोल के तो उनको भी वो नहीं सुनेगा हमारा बात, तो क्या वो क्या बोलेगा वही सुनना पड़ेगा आपको. आई एम जस्ट वो एज ए सेइंग एज ए लेमैन आई नो दैट दीज आर ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स आर देयर व्हाइल ऑपरेटिंग द मशीन्स. देयर इज द प्रॉपर अंडरस्टैंडिंग and the behavior of the machine also we should know, then only we can get the best output from the machine. Yes, we know that over the period of time there are different problems of aap rassi bandhne ka mechanism mein bhi kuch bahut din ke baad aap theek se if you are not maintaining then the problem also will arise over there in the machine performance.
Yes,
that means aap kya combine harvester prefer kar rahe hain?
नहीं नहीं सर, वैसे तो मशीन सही है, वो तो मेरे को पता है क्योंकि हमने इसको
नहीं, I'm not,
काम तो हमारा बहुत जल्दी होता।
जी मैं एक मशीन को एडवर्टाइज करने के लिए नहीं आया हूँ इधर. यस, ऑल द मशीन्स आर हैविंग देयर ओन एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस. या हम एक कंपनी के
ओके ओके
लिए रिप्रेजेंट नहीं है, मीन्स यस मशीन्स में भी कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स है, आई कैन से दैट. या दैट इज व्हाट द परफॉर्मेंस वाइज डिफरेंट मशीन्स आर हैविंग डिफरेंट परफॉर्मेंस. एज आई हैव इंडिकेटेड देयर फील्ड कैपेसिटी, हाउ मच फ्यूल कैन दे कैन कंज्यूम. As a one machine, I have showed to you. If I compare the same like vertical conveyor reaper for 10
Yes.
companies, then there is a variation among all the companies also.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good, Satyendra, it is a very
You know.
good, yeah. That is what, if we know, once you operate, then only you can give us the feedback. What is the performance of the machine and how we can able to. Thereby we can analyze what all the problems are there and all in these machines. Okay. Any other
Okay,
query?
sir.
Yeah. From the participant side, yes. Any other query?
Sir, related to the sprayer, right? Nowadays, drone also being used.
Exactly. Yeah.
And is there any research done in IIT to bring a low cost drone
Yeah,
kind of?
it is. Yeah, we have already started. It is going on. We are reducing the cost of the drone. Main thing is the capacity, means how much payload it can able to carry. Okay, the research is initiated over here in IIT Kharagpur, and we are planning to make a small drone. As of now, I could not able to reveal the values. Once we come up with the results, surely I will share the values with you.
Okay, yeah, that will be very helpful to the farmers. Okay,
Exactly. Yeah.
and it would
Anyway,
have
even now it
lower.
is very popular. Even we have seen lot of the college researchers or students are also, they are very fascinated about this technology. They can even
Right.
able to make their own, and there are a lot of startups are also there in this particular area
Right, sir.
related to the drone-based spraying applications.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. And even I can say that anyway, as an open platform, we can use the drone not only for spraying application. We can monitor the crop, means what is the disease which got infected into the crop, and we can just check the health condition of the crop using the drone. Even we can estimate the yield also based on the crop. As I have
Correct.
indicated, plant population and all, right? We can estimate directly how much yield the crop going to give at the end of the cultivation.
Right, sir.
We
And
can
also,
do that.
maybe it may be useful for some seeding also in some.
Yes. Yeah, like the small broadcasting kind of thing, it is also very useful. But as a mechanical harvesters or as an engineer, normally we won't recommend the broadcasting operation. Suppose if we allow the drone to sprinkle the seeds into the field, the uniformity may not be there because the seed is falling from the top to bottom, right? They
Correct.
want to, there is a uniformity between the plant or to seed or row spacing.
Correct.
Okay. Yeah, because of that, again, is a competition, right? In the small area, more number of seeds are there, they will compete for getting the food, like nutrition, air, water, and all. Again, it will affect the yield also. Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Sir, good evening, sir. This is
Yes.
Motesh Mohan, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, like the paddy seedling mat, it can be you pro tray also can be used, sir.
Pro trays, these are all cells are there, right? In the pro tray.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, if you are going for SRA cultivation, but you have to make accordingly the pro tray because.
No, I'm not talking about paddy, sir. We are talking about vegetable
Yeah,
seedlings.
vegetables, yes, it is the pro tray only. Yes, we pro tray only.
Okay, it is available, sir.
It is available. Even pro tray planting machines are also available. We have
Okay.
developed machines over here also.
Okay, sir. That is manual or mechanical, sir?
Yes, exactly. In the greenhouse, whenever in the nurseries, when they are planting and in pro trays, they are doing it as manual. But mechanical transplanters, mechanical planters, or pro tray seeders are also available in the market.
Okay. It's
And
developed by IIT Kharagpur, sir.
yes, in Kharagpur also we have done.
Is it commercially available to the farmers, sir?
Actually, we have just completed the research and we got the mechanism. Actually, we have planted that one for as a at a time single cell. but we are making it as a multi-cell at a time. That means as a row wise, we just want to sow the seed into the protrace, filling the soil, putting the seed, and again covering the seed also. These are three operations are coupled along with the watering operations.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Any other query? Surely I will share all these machines in the next season. Okay. Anyway, we will be running such program on this particular platform. I will show related to the drone technology, robotics, and all. Yeah. Satyendra? Mr.
Yes.
Satyendra, you want to say something?
Yes, yes. No, sir, no.
Okay, okay. Okay, then I am continuing. I'll show some of the robotic machines are also available. I'll just throw a light onto that also at the end of this session. I'm continuing.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, don't you think so ki, that much of machines are very costly for the marginal farmers? How can they buy that costly machines?
Which one? Combine harvester.
Each process there is a machine, right?
Yes.
So how can government can does government can provide them the subsidy or the machines? How can they do these things?
That is why the government is coming with a lot of schemes, like as a self-help groups or custom hiring centers, whichever the locality, they are just encouraging the younger generation. Thereby, they can go with as a subsidy also they are providing, like depends on the location and depending on the state. The subsidy range is there between 10 to 40% for some machines. Even for some machines, 50% is also available. The details are available under the website of the government, like farmers, and you can get under this one machine on agricultural mechanization. Sub machine on agricultural mechanization. If you just check, they are given the subsidy for different states and what all the government schemes are there. Directly as a farmer, if you can able to afford to purchase that machine, you can register online directly. The provision is also available. To purchase that, or as a self-help group or custom hiring center, if the younger generation, if they want to go with as a startup, that is also encouraged. You can apply, and based on that, the subsidy schemes are also available.
Okay, sir. Another one question is, you had shown the sowing equipment for the paddy, right? Is there any machines for sugarcane orchards and?
Yes. Yeah, are there? I have indicated for one vegetable transplanter. Similarly, yes, the machines are there for sugar cane. Rather than entire sugar cane, we can cut only the bud. We have developed at IIT Kharagpur. That particular bud we can place into the field.
And so we already have used the drone for the spraying of gomutra. Organic biofertilizer for the more than 200 acre of area, and that is that gives very good result.
Okay, so, good. Which sprayer you have used?
Drone with a
drone based spraying application. Yeah, okay.
Yes.
You have taken that one, or on a custom hiring, somebody has done this particular operation?
Yeah, it's customized, and we get help from the other farmers. And
exactly.
It's on the training. They trained us how to use the drone as a sprayer for the large land.
Okay. Can you tell how much is the payload of that particular drone, or any idea?
20 liter.
20 liter. Okay. Price?
Price, I don't remember the price, but 20 liter is there, and it takes 2 hours to cover the 2 hectares of land. It's in UP, sir. We used in UP.
Good. Okay. Good.
In which place?
Yeah.
In which place? Yes, sir. In which place you are belong, ma'am?
Bulandshahr.
Drone base sprayer.
Yes, yes. We adjusted the sprayer on the drone, and that we used it for the on the land.
Was it cost efficient?
Sorry.
Was it cost efficient? What cost did you get on that to customize that drone?
Because it's on training, ma'am. It's on training. We used on training. So I exactly don't know the cost. We just used and show the results.
It was a demo. For demonstration purpose only, okay?
Yeah.
Okay,
sir. Thank you.
Good. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, I'll be continuing with this one. Yeah, surely we will show the other technologies also in the upcoming seasons, and we will provide you the other information related to the cost of each unit.
Sir.
Yes, Sandeep.
One of our friends in Nasik, they're developing a drone taxi project, person. They are successful with 150 kg payload.
Okay.
That can be customized and used for spraying also.
Okay. Anyway, I have given my the email ID. You can also share your information. Surely I will communicate this one to the other locations also. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I'm just going with the other part. Yes. Now, the thing we have seen, the harvesting, then binding, as Satyendra has mentioned, that is, there are little issues are there related to binding, and after that going for the threshing. Keeping all these operations are like very hectic, and time is availability of the time is very less. That is why the new concept, anyway, it is the concept, the combined harvester concept has come into picture. Here we have the different functional processes like the cutting and gathering the crop and cutting. Cutting again includes like sometimes for some crops we just have to pick like maize, we just have to pick the corn cob, that process, and again after threshing and separating separation of the foreign material from the crop, and the cleaning and storing, all these operations are combined together in one particular unit. That is why name has come as combined harvester. Operations like cutting or harvesting, threshing, separating, cleaning, and storing all together are there in the combined harvester. Here I have just showed what is happening in a combined harvester as a outline, the sketch. Here at the front, we have the crop divider, this one, this particular unit. It divides the crop in a row, how much crop it can able to cut at a time. The both the sides, it can divide. Once it divides, the crop will be dragged towards the cutter bar by rail. The rail is rotating, it will drag the crop towards the cutter bar. Now here the cutting operation is happening. It is like a cutter bar, like a scissoring action, we can cut the crop. After cutting the crop, there is a conveyor, that or feeder conveyor, that feeds the crop to the threshing cylinder. This is the threshing cylinder. Means it is collecting the crop and allowing that one on a layer by layer to the threshing unit. Here we have a again conveyor unit. This is the feeder conveyor. This is the conveyor to the thresher. It conveys the crop. The crop is going the red color arrow. Here in this particular location, the threshing cylinder is there. The threshing cylinder, after cutting the crop, it separates the grain from the crop. This is the threshing cylinder. Below that, we have the concave. Through that threshing cylinder, we can the seed is getting falling down, or the crop, the grains are falling down. If you observe here, the both chaff as well as grain together, or straw as well as the grain, are coming at this location out from the threshing cylinder. Now they are coming onto the sieve. These are all different stack of sieves are available. We can separate the grain from the straw or chaff. Just below this sieve, we have a blower. The blower blows out the air. The air movement is this way. That is why it can able to clean the grain from the different layers of the sieve. See, there are three stacks are there. We can clean the grain in three locations. Now, once the grain is cleaned, whatever the chaff and straw, it is coming out from the combine harvester at this location. The clean grain will be coming into this particular auger. Auger is as a conveyor. It conveys the grain, the clean grain, to the grain tank. It is kept onto the top of the these units, onto the overhead tank. Grain tank is there. Thereby we can able to allow the clean grain into the grain tank. Once the grain tank is filled, then again we have another auger. From that auger, we can take out that one to any other truck or trolley separately. Whenever the operation or grain tank is full, the combine harvester can transport this particular clean grain to the other location. Here anyway, we have these units are all called as straw walkers. Means they are separating the straw out from the grain. And here we have the return chute. Sometimes this is the clean grain is going to the overhead tank. Sometimes the grain is not threshed properly. That is also coming over here along with the straw and some grain. It is taking back to the threshing unit. With another conveyor, we can transport this particular unit to the threshing cylinder. Again, the second time the threshing will happen, and clean grain we can able to get out from the machine, and that will be stored into the grain tank. These are all the different components of the combine harvester. We have the combine harvesters for cereal crops and pulses, or different crops like sunflower and maize. Also, we have the combine harvesters. Even the combine harvesters are also available for sugar cane crop also. Only the cost is very high of these particular machines, and that is why the number is also very less. And as a custom hiring part, we can able to acquire these machines. Now, the another machine is the thresher. Suppose I want to go for only the harvesting, and I can dry the crop. Then after that, I can take the crop and I can thresh. There are different threshers are available for crops like cereals and pulses. As I have indicated earlier, threshers are also available for that. In these threshers, this is the feeding tray. We can feed both grain and the crop over here. It will enter into the only the particular threshing unit. I have showed it over here. Here, it will just come to the threshing cylinder. Anyway, the cover is there onto the top. In the threshing cylinder, the cylinder is rotating, and that will drag the crop and thresh the grain. The clean grain along with the chaff is falling down. Here also we have the upper oscillating screen, or the straw walkers are there. Now, because of this rotation, thereby even it will throw out the straw out to the other location. The crop is entering it one direction, and the outlet of the straw is coming out. The threshed crop with the chaff and grain is falling down. And here also we have the blower. The blower blows out, and it will remove the chaff from the grain. The clean grain will be collected over here at this particular grain discharge auger. And from this, we can able to collect the grain into a bag or into a storage unit. This is the thresher. Now, I'll be showing you the combine harvester. As I have indicated, the different operations of the combine harvester, like gathering the crop, cutting, conveying to the threshing cylinder, and again after threshing, separation of the straw and the grain. The clean grain is going to the tank. Again, the unthreshed grain is coming back to the threshing cylinder. You can observe here cutter bar here, it is 14 feet length. It is gathering. Then after that, after gathering, see, this is the cutting mechanism. Thereby the crop is cut. After cutting the crop, it is conveyed into the threshing cylinder. After threshing, the clean grain is coming out from the auger into the overhead tank. These are all the straw workers. We can separate the straw, and the plower is also plowing. Thereby we can clean the grain out. These are the straw workers. You can observe that the straw is coming after threshing. All these operations are combined together. It is a combined harvester. The price may vary between 9.5 to 21.5 lakh. Here, whatever the thresher I have showed is as a the Smosh company. Even we have the other companies also, like tractor operated combined harvesters are also there. We have Class India, John Deere, Mahindra, and Mahindra. All they are also coming with the combined harvesters. If you see the performance wise, here I have indicated we have the variants also in the combine harvester, like mini self propelled combine harvester, tractor drawn combine harvester is there, and track type combine harvester, four wheel drive type combine harvester are there. The engine power also I have indicated, mini self propelled is 101 HP, 101 HP, and tractor drawn 55 to 70 HP tractor can be used for operating this combine harvester. Here, the cutting width is 3.6 meters per tractor operated, also 3.6 meter. The cutting height of the crop, we can go with like a 50 millimeter, means 5 centimeters height. It can able to cut to a length of the entire crop, like 1.25 meters, it can cut. And for field capacity wise, wheat, it can do for 3 acres per hour, and for paddy, 2 acres per hour. In 1 acre, we can harvest 2 acres. For 1 hour for the wheat, we can harvest 3 acres. The weight of machine is also given per year. Now the tractor drawn combine harvester, the cutting specification is almost same. If you see the field capacity, it is only 1 to 1.5 acre per hour, and for paddy it is 2 to 2.5 acre per hour. Now the track type combine harvester, we can harvest in 1 hour 1 acre. And weight is also given. And the track type, wherever the wetland is there, where the slip is as a major concern, it is the farmers are preferring the track type combine harvester. We have even the four-wheel drive type combine harvesters are also available in the market. This is for the paddy, as a cereal crop, paddy and wheat I have showed over here. Now, there are combine harvesters for maize crop also. The first mechanical corn harvester was developed in 1930s by Glenner Harvester Combined Corporation of Independence, Missouri. They have developed this one in Punjab also. One machine is available. The Preet Group, they have just developed, and they have already released this particular maize combine harvester. It is a 10 HP. And cutting width is 3.4 meter. The grain tank capacity and weight, some specifications also are given. You can observe the maize combine harvester. Here also we have crop divider, and it is gathering the crop and cutting at the bottom and conveying the entire crop. After threshing, we can see the chaff out, coming out. And the clean grain will be taken into the grain tank. The entire crop is fed into the threshing cylinder. The corn cobs will be threshed along with the crop. And the clean grain, after cleaning, it will be transferred to the grain tank. These are all the different cleaning units, and finally we can get the chaff out from this particular machine. Now, as a planting for different other crops, I am just showing here for potato. We have the potato planter. The potato planter, here we can pick the potatoes one by one and we can plant it. Potato planter is a sowing implement hitched behind a tractor with a three-point linkage system. Here the metering unit is a cup lift seed potatoes from a hopper. It will, all the cups will pick the potato one by one and they will drop into the furrow via the seed tube. The machine is, the different components I have showed here. This is the metering unit, means it is picking the potatoes one by one. Cup feeding mechanism is there. And the second one, the entire hopper, we can fill the potatoes. The three here, after picking, seed tube is there that will be delivering the seed from the hopper to the furrow. Here we have the ground wheel. This ground wheel will give the indication, means what is the seed rate I have to plant into the field. The mechanism, the chain and sprocket arrangement and metering units are there. Thereby, we can able to change the seed rate into the field, means how many kgs of potatoes we have to plant into the field. That also can be controlled with this particular mechanism. The entire frame is there. It will be connected to the tractor with the hitch system. At the bottom, backside, if you see, the ridger is there. We can follow as a ridge. We can plant the potato and we can cover the soil as a ridge with the height. And finally, we can even able to make the top of the ridges flat using this particular levelers over behind the machine. If you see the specifications of the machines, different potato planters which are available, we can go with the two row or three row. Our power requirement is 40 to 60 HP. Power is required for two row, and for three row, 60 to 70 HP tractors we can employ for doing this operation. And row to row distance, if you go with that between two rows, the distance will be like 600 to 660 millimeter, like 0.6 to 0.66 meters. This is same. And plant to plant spacing also we can maintain like 10 centimeter to 45 centimeter plant to plant spacing. And working depth or 10 centimeter to 15 centimeter depth we can plant. And weight of the machine is also given as 580 for two row and 880 kg of for three row. I'll just show this particular the Smash Agro Industries Punjab. They have developed they have indicated the price of this machine as 70,000 with the GST approximately. And you can observe that, see, this is the hopper. You can fill the potatoes and the potatoes are picked one by one by the mechanism. And here you can observe that it is even forming the ridges. These are all called as ridges. We can fill the potato and cover with the soil and form as a ridge, the furrow and ridge. Furrow is the down part, ridge is the top part. Thereby we can give the water in these furrows. This is the potato planter. If you see the performance of the machine, the field capacity is 0.2 to 0.3 hectares per hour. As in 4 hours, we can cover 1 hectare. Field efficiency is 65 to 75%. That is the another parameter, field efficiency. Field efficiency means theoretically, the machine which is operating at 2.5 to 4 kilometer per hour with a width or working width of suppose two room is 1.2 meter length and at a speed of 2.5 kilometer per hour, how much it can able to cover the area, that area per unit time will be multiplied with this field efficiency, 65 to 75%. Why this much the efficiency is reduced here means, as I indicated, there is a turning and we have to fill the hoppers with the seed. All these factors as a time is included, means more time is wasted in turning and filling the things, and that is why we are getting the field efficiency of 65 to 75%, because it depends on the crop. means how frequently we have to fill the hopper and all. Even some of the machines have a little higher efficiency, like 80 to 85 efficiency also. It includes that the frequency of filling and turning, all these factors are included in this particular field efficiency parameter. The seed rate, you can operate at 2000 to 2500 kg seed per 1 hour. We can able to plant in this using this particular machine. Now we have planted the potato. Anyway, we can go with intercultural weeding and all those operations, protection and all. Again, it is as a potato digger. We can dig the potatoes. Here I have showed as a potato digger is a machine for digging up the potatoes, removing the tops and dirt from the tubers and throwing the tubers out onto the field. Here, whatever we have showed here is that the potatoes are allowed onto the top of the surface. Thereby, we can pick the potatoes. Even the combined potato diggers are also available. Means we can separate the potatoes and convey the potatoes and we can bag them. That such machines are also available. But as an individual unit of a potato digger, I'm showing it over here. The Land Power Agrotech Private Limited Punjab, they have this particular machine and they have indicated 70,000. It is tractor operated digger. You can observe the different parts here. We have the this is the digging unit. It will penetrate into the soil and dig the soil along with the tubers. The potatoes are all tubers. Once we take the soil along with the tubers, here we have the conveyor. It is a special type of conveying unit. It is having a agitate, means the oscillatory motion, means it will agitate the soil and the tubers together. Thereby, the tubers will be allowed onto the top and soil will fall down at the bottom. And at the behind, we have a roller. The roller will compact the soil. And whatever the tubers are coming out, the tubers will be separated from the soil and they will be laying onto the ground at the back of the machine. Here, it is getting the power from the power takeoff unit. The tractor is having a P2 pump. Behind the tractor, there is one shaft that is called power takeoff that we can connect to the this unit of the machine with the help of any the universal joint or universal coupling. With that, we can transmit the power for this conveyor. See here, the power is transmitted for conveyor. Here we have the oscillatory mechanism also. Thereby, it will agitate the conveyor, like up and down, it will just oscillate. And because of that, the soil will be separated from the tubers. And behind we have a roller also. The roller will compact and we can allow the potato to fall behind the machine. The specifications, if you observe, we can go with 8 attempt 2 rows. The spacing is more. That is why for this one, we can go with as a 2 row crops, 2 row machine. Power required, the tractor power, we can use 40 to 60 HP tractor. Working width is, as I indicated, 1.4 meter. Is the width 1.4 meter or 1400 millimeter is the width, working width. That means row to row spacing is coming here as like 70 centimeter between the two rows. Now working depth, we can operate at a depth of 13 to 20 centimeter or 130 to 200 millimeter depth. Weight of this machine is 600 kg. You'll see the operation once again. See here, the roller is also there. The roller is compacting the soil. Then only we can get the potatoes under the top. Otherwise, again, the potatoes also will get submerged into the soil. That is why the roller is kept over there to separate the potatoes from the soil. See here, the soil and potatoes both are coming together and soil is separated and potatoes will be laying down onto the field. At a time, you can observe that the two rows, that is why in between two rows, they are left for the next run. We're coming back side, coming back, they'll cover the other two rows. previously we have seen the potato planter, now this is the potato or digger. Field capacity is 0.35 to 0.4 hectare per hour. That means in 2.5 hours we can cover 1 hectare. Field efficiency of this one is 75% to 80%, and speed of operation is 2 to 4 km/h. But anyway, the operators are operating little high speed. That is why we can get potatoes and the soil block also along with the potatoes. The performance is the main parameter. It depends whatever the manufacturer has recommended. We have to go with that. Then only we can get the best performance. Otherwise, such problems will be there. Yes, now this is about the groundnut harvester. As like a potato as a tuber, we have the groundnut also. A groundnut, we have to pick the plant and we have to separate the pods of the groundnut from the plant. Then later on we can thresh. But here, whatever I have showed you is the groundnut digger. Like as a potato digger, we have the groundnut harvester also. Here, the groundnut harvester is equipment used for digging, shaking to remove the dead soil, windrowing, and removal of groundnut parts from the vines. These are all the operations are there in the groundnut harvester. If you observe here also, we have like it is just separating the entire width and cutting on the soil. And here it will just dig into the soil and it will separate the crop, potato, from the soil. And it will be taken up with the conveyor. And this conveyor again will allow the crop to lay down onto the ground. After drying, we can pick up the pods out from the field. Here, even this is the digging blade is also kept at the front. These two are the discs which can separate the crop width from the field. If you see the specifications, we have the width of operation of this one in centimeters is given here, 100 to 200, that means 1 meter to 2 meter. Power is a 30 to 90 HP tractor we can use. Working width is like 1.5 meter as it is 1 to 2 meter I have indicated. Working depth is a 10 centimeter to 15 centimeter. Weight is 600 kilogram of this particular machine. We can use as the weight of the horsepower of the tractor in the range of 30 to 90 HP based on the working width. You can observe in the field, it is just digging the crop, groundnut, and separating the soil and allowing the groundnut to fall side by. Even the combines are also available. They can even take out the plant and separate the parts out from the groundnut. But the groundnut diggers are preferred some places. Reason is that we can allow the crop to dry for few days. The next one also you can see. You can see that the plants with pods, they are coming out from the machine. After separating the soil. Yes, we have harvested the crop, and for paddy, the another nowadays because of the crop stubble burning is an issue, and in Punjab and all these locations, there is a, as I indicated yesterday also, the pollution problem. Anyway, we have the happy seeder and super seeders are available to overcome such problems. There is another machine called as baling equipment. Even we can collect the straw and we can bale it or we can roll it. And we can even use this bales, the straw bales. We can sell these bales to any paper industry and all. The balers are also available. in the market as a Redland. They have given the baler. I'm indicating over here. The balers are used to bale the rice straw, wheat straw, and corn harvest residues. Even sugarcane harvest waste also we can bale with even in cotton crop, cotton stalks also. Different balers are available. The specifications I have indicated. This machine can be operated with the 25 to 60 HP tractor range. The machines are available. We can use the P2O power, and the bale length we can use 70 centimeter length, and the diameter we can get up to 50 centimeter, and the bale, whatever the bale we are making, its weight we can get in the weight range of 15 to 20 kg. I'll just show the operation. We are just hitching to the tractor. It's 3-point hitch, and there is a power also we can transmit from the P2O. This you can observe, we are just connecting with the power takeoff P2O of the tractor with the machine using the universal joint. Now once we allow that one to move onto the field, it is collecting the straw. After using combine harvesters, the entire stack and straw will be allowed to fall onto the field. That we can collect and we can make the bales, and as an entire bale we can release onto the field. Later on these bales we can collect with any trolley or truck, we can transport to the other location. This is about the baler. And if you see the field capacity, 0.25 hectares per 1 hour, means 4 hours are required to operate 1 hectare. And forward speed 1.8 to 2 kilometer per hour speed we can do. The fuel consumption 2 liters it can consume per hour. Baling efficiency means how much straw it can able to collect means 96%. It can clean the field. The cost of operation per hectare wise is given as 4,472 rupees per hectare is the cost if we operate with this particular machine. As a custom hiring also, we can get this.
Sir, your screen is not visible, sir.
Screen is not visible. Only to you or to
me? I don't know, sir, whether it is it me only or for others also. I don't know.
No, sir, visible.
Visible.
In my presentation.
Yeah, I have pinned your that. Till now, okay. It was visible.
Okay.
Really, I don't know.
Okay. Once again, I'm operating for you. You can see this. Here, the operator is hitching the implement and connecting with the PTO. The power is taken from power takeoff unit for baling the straw. This machine is collecting the straw from the ground into the field and making as a bale and releasing onto the field. The bale diameter we can get 50 centimeter. The length of the bale, 70 centimeter, we can get with this particular machine. It is tractor operated. We can use a tractor power of like 32, 40 HP or 25 to 60 HP. Power range is also there. These machines are available based on the working width. Anyway, one more thing I'm just showing nowadays, the popular thing is that in some of the location where the irrigation facility is not there for pumping water as a water pump, which requires power, we can go with the solar panels. We can connect, and the solar operated irrigation pump sets are also available in the market. I hope this topic was covered by Professor K.N. Tiwari sir in the previous lecture. I have just given some specifications which are available in the market for water pumping. We also have tested over here. There's a small setup with one panel, how much it can able to get. If it is a shallow well and deep well with the photovoltaic, the solar panel array we got, and of 2.7 kilowatt to 3 kilowatt power, and we have coupled with a 3 HP a motor. Then with that we can get a water of this much capacity per day, and at a depth of 20 meter to 50 meter. These are all some of the findings. Now I'm just going with the advanced which are harvesters are available. You can observe here we have the orchard crop harvesters directly. The canopy also we can shake and we can harvest the crop by shaking. All the fruits will fall down and we can collect with another mechanism. Here also you can observe that after shaking the entire tree, the fruits are falling down and there is another conveyor to collect the fruits. Such harvesters are also available for fruit harvesting. Most of these fruit harvesters are like as a manually. Still many fruit harvesters are available in India and are used extensively. As a single one by one fruit also we can pick, or as a bulk, we can allow this particular machine and we can shake the canopy or the trunk. Thereby the entire fruits will fall down and we can collect those fruits. The manual fruit harvester, DNAU, they have developed with these specifications like capacity 65 kg per hour we can harvest, and there are like multi-one tree shakers are also available with the specifications. We can cover like 40 to 60 trees per hour with a capacity of 540 kg of fruit we can collect. The diameter of that particular shaker is 6 meter range, we can able to get that. The trunk diameter, we can use this machine for a 35 centimeter trunk diameter. You can observe the different fruit harvesters. After harvesting, the fruits are conveyed. Yes, the next thing is use of robotics for harvesting or planting. If you see the robotics, we can use these robotics for transplanting, spraying operation, pruning. Frequently we have to prune the branches of the crop, the orchards, and we can use for weeding operation, and we can go for harvesting and for post-harvest handling and sorting and grading. All these operations we can do using a robotics in agriculture. We have like a robotic apple harvester is there. As I have showed earlier, we can shake the crop, either canopy, we can collect the fruits. But as a robot, we can pick fruit one by one. It will just detect the fruit, and based on its ripeness, it will just pick the fruit. And we have the cucumber harvester robot is also there. I have indicated the inventor of this particular robot. Even it can just, there will be a camera. It will keep on monitor the different locations of the crop. Whenever it finds that there is a matured cucumber or matured fruit or vegetable, it will go there and it will just cut that one, and it will place it in the harvested fruit or vegetable into the collecting unit or collecting hopper. Actually here the specifications I have given, it is a Mitsubishi, the gripper they are using, the motor gripper specifications and average success rate. Means out of 174, it can accurately pick 74%. How much time it takes for picking one is 65.2 seconds. It is also indicated. We can increase this process quickness, or we can reduce the time. Fruits detached in single attempt. It has detached like 53 fruits out of 100. As a research outcome, I have indicated over here. Such things are there, as you have mentioned, the drones for spraying, and we can even monitor the crop. We can use the robots for all these operations. Here you can observe that there is a on particular video. There you can observe that, see how it is picking the fruit and placing into the tray. There is a mechanism, it is just sensing the different crops. And 1 minute. Here you can sense the different fruits as it entire diameter. It is showing which are all the fruits got ripened. Directly we can go to that location and pick that fruit, and we can place it into the collection unit. Otherwise we can prune using this robot. We can prune the crop also when pruning is required. See, the pruner is there, and we have like the automated. Even we can use the solar power also for giving the power to the operation of the machine. This is like a weeder. Here it is just checking, scanning the different plants, and in between it is just operating a tool for weeding, means removing the weeds. The same mechanism also we can use for spraying applications. We can spray the liquid or the pesticide as the entire robot. It can do the different operations. Even these robots are also we can use for monitoring the crop, means whether it is disease infected or not. We can even place the seed. We can do the intercultural operations. See, you can, it can water the plants. All such operations we can do with this robots. With this, with a little advanced technologies, I'm just ending. The way is there for our farmers. Rather than saying as a farmer, is the entire youth, the educated youth, they are also now planning towards the agriculture sector. If you all come together, we can surely bring up our country's agriculture sector as the prime unit for contributing to our gross domestic production. Thereby we can serve in terms of agriculture sector wise, as well as industrial sector wise and service sector wise. Thereby our manpower also effectively utilized with all this knowledge, and we can contribute to our country. With that, I'm just ending my session. Now the participants, they can interact with me. Thank you for giving this chance to me to display what are all the technologies, the limited technologies I have just showed to you. The knowledge is very vast. Surely we will come up with the different sessions in future, and we will show what are all the developed technologies are there at our Kharagpur. We will demonstrate to you. Thank you.
Hello. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, sugar cancer related कोई भी technology नहीं है?
Is there sugar cane? Actually, we have the sugar cane bud planter is there with us, and even while planting itself, we can spray the insecticide. See, when we cut the sugar cane is having different buds. Buds means the set. Whenever the different sets are there, where you can get the plant, the germinated plant, that unit is called as the bud. That we can separate. Rather than previous days, we used to plant the entire cane after making into as a small pieces, the sets. Rather than avoiding that, means we are using the edible part also as a seed. We can cut that one and we can take only the bud. That bud we can plant into the soil, and we can protect that bud from the insects and pest. We can apply the pest also at a time in this particular machine. It is also available, but I have not included here. Yes, actually I will show that part in the next thing.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, any query?
Sir, please you provide your mail ID, sir. I get your mail ID.
Okay, I'm just indicating here. Yesterday also given in the video, but I'm typing once again the same email ID. This is my email ID. You can contact or you can share the information. thereby you can circulate to the other participants also. Any query from the participant side?
Sir,
yes,
Motesh Mohan here, sir. Sir, yes, we live in a hilly district.
Okay.
The problem is all the machineries which have been approved by the centers,
yes,
are not applicable here, sir. That is a problem.
Yeah.
So what to do about that, sir?
That is what, rather than going with as a heavy machinery, the small units are available. That is why the robot technology is becoming popular. Sir, small unit, we can take it into the field as a for small land holding capacity. Now the machines are also available for small lands or small fields. We can easily handle it. We can just lift it, the machine, and take it over to the field.
If we are going for DBT portal, sir,
okay,
half the machineries are not being approved.
Yeah.
By that, yes, there is no Pudini certificate or S certificates for these machineries.
Yeah.
So that is the problem we are having.
Yeah. Actually, your center, there are different centers in the country. Your center, the northeastern zone center, they are developing the machine related to the areas. Okay, I'm just sharing one website over here, thereby you can get the information related to the subsidy and all. I think most few of you might be knowing about this one. Let me just share. This is the digital platform for farm mechanization and technology. Here you can get the different options like the direct benefit transfer in agriculture. Is it visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
No, sir, not visible to me.
No, sir, no, sir.
Then again, some problem.
Visible, sir, visible.
Is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, for you want to go for form the testing of the machines, or direct benefit transfer in agriculture mechanization. I'm just sharing this one. See how many manufacturers have registered as of now, and what are the different societies or self-help groups are registered under this. If you directly register online, you have to apply for the application, and based on the machine, even what is the subsidy available, all the guidelines are also there indicated in this particular website. For how many applications or what is the amount they have approved the subsidy also, they have given over here. The project also they have given for the former actually is around now. Once the application for purchasing the instrument is ready, then if you submit that one, the collection of application by lottery or the first come first serve basis, they are doing that. And after the bill payment to the dealer directly, after paying that, the remaining as a subsidy, it will be deposited into the farmer's account. You can also frequently check this website. You can get the details or how to track or what are the subsidy calculations you can able to do, for which state you are doing this one. For all the options are also available. Suppose I want to go for West Bengal, and what is the different scheme? The schemes are also available. And which implement I want to purchase, all the implements are also listed over here for different implements. And we can, as a male or female, that the how much land we have and what is the dealer price, all the things if you can submit, you can able to get how much amount you can get as a subsidy. Those details also you can able to calculate all the details are available in this particular website. You can interact over here. Related to the subsidy aspects. Okay.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
All this technology.
Which one?
Is for all these technologies are for rich people, rich farmers.
I could not able to, yeah, pardon, please.
All the technologies are available, yes, for rich farmers. Maybe in India, 90% farmers are, yeah, marginal farmers, small landholders.
Yeah.
How can we help them, sir?
How can they use the machines, right?
Nowadays, labor cost is increasing and labors are not available in farm now.
Yes, exactly,
At least in Maharashtra.
Yeah.
We are facing a lot of labor shortage.
Yes.
How to overcome this problem, sir?
How to overcome the labor shortage problem, right? The
labor problem is there. Technology is available for rich farmers. What about poor farmers? Nobody is thinking for poor farmers, marginal farmers. How can we approach them or how can we cater to them?
Anyway, and a lot of solutions are there for this one. Yes, it is good that, we have to think of the... See, whenever the farmer word is coming, but we are saying poor farmers. Right, that itself is a very the thing. Yeah, main thing is that the farmer is supporting the entire country. They are just cultivating and feeding the country, and the entire youth. I don't know how many. Anyway, on this platform, I cannot ask you also how many people are interested to support the farmers or to transfer the information to the farmers or to are interested to do the cultivation. That is the main thing, right?
Yes.
Yeah. If the youth, if they are coming forward, as exactly we say the poor farmer means they are illiterate, like that, all these things we are there in our mind. Related to a lot of farmers, they don't know about what are the schemes are running in the state and how to approach the state officials to get the proper guidance and all. If like us, that is why we have started this training platform and all. If all the youth, literate youth, if they come forward and support the farmers, yes, we can slowly take out the poor word from the farmer. And I am also as a farmer. If I feel that, yes, we can also do the cultivation and we can support. Okay.
Because the young generation is not coming into farming now. That is a very sad situation.
Okay.
Yeah, sir, one more input here. Basically, yes, the farmer producer organization, it's all about collective farming.
Yes.
No more poor farmer cutting, and all of them join together. They have a good capacity.
Exactly.
Participation and subsidy and profitable.
Exactly.
In Bihar also, they are only marginal farmers only, and they are making group and they are purchasing the equipment and they are sharing it.
Yes.
Because most of the farmers are the marginal farmers. They are making their own groups and purchasing it. The equipment are with the group and they are utilizing it services.
Yeah, as I have indicated previous yesterday's lecture also, whatever the machine we have, we cannot use that one the 100%, right? Suppose I am using the transplanter, whatever the field I have, I can use that. The remaining time, I can spare that one to the either marginal farmer or the poor farmer, whatever the word we can mention, we can support them. The farmers as a group, they can come forward and they can support with each other as a self-help group. Surely such problems we can overcome, but yes, this understanding should also be there among the groups, and as a group, if they can come, as you have mentioned, like Ramalingam has mentioned, and Divya Bharati, they have also mentioned, yes, surely we can able to come up. The thing is that as a you also please think about this one. I'm saying as a thing, it is not like as a thing. You can also support, you can disseminate the information to the farmer. Where the seed is available, what is the cost of the seed, where the custom hiring centers are available, how to contact them, and what is the price per hour. See, it is also like, anyway, different middle people are coming, and even the cost is also not as a standardized from state to state. It is also again as a demand basis. The price is also getting increased. Suppose I want to hire a combine harvester. There are the locations per hour they make charge like 500 rupees. And the same per hour, there are some locations where they can charge as a 3,500 rupees per hour for doing the combine harvesting operation in the field. That is what. If we have this understanding, surely we can able to reduce the cost of operation and we can give the profit to the farmer. Yes, we can support the
We have a food farmers producers organization, sir, FPOs.
Yes,
where we are a group of 500 farmers, and the FPOs are having a common machineries, storage places, or this processing units, and it is benefiting all the farmers, sir. And to be a part of an FPO, they are paying a bare minimum of 1,000 rupees only to be a member, and are getting a lot of benefits like the selling their products or procuring for other members also who wanted to procure a product without a middleman. These FPOs are playing a lead role, sir. Even many farm now it is upcoming, sir. It is, I don't know whether it is it's slowly gaining popular among the farmers. Yes. And also this farmers producers company also, they are doing a great job, sir, in just in helping the marginal farmers, because everybody they can't buy those things, and in that case this FPOs and FPCs are helping those farmers in renting out on a very nominal charges, sir.
Exactly. Yeah, that is what, with the digital technology we can able to communicate with each other, and we can able to know what are the different prices and how there is an improvement in the particular locality as a self-help group or a POs and all. That information we can share with the other locations of the country. I hope that we can able to support the poor and marginal farmers.
With the smartphone, now every farmers are having a smartphone, and now it is and with the WhatsApp and the social media communication, slowly now they are also getting involved with the technology, sir. So we can say that all farmers are illiterate. We can make them literate. All the upcoming farmers or entrepreneurs or whoever it is, they can make them understand those things.
Yeah, and one more thing, as an academic unit also, we should require your feedback. Miss, you are all there at different locations. And what is the status of the farmer over there? How they are getting problem for which particular operation? Even these machines, I will not give the guarantee 100% that whatever the machine I can use in West Bengal, I may not give you 100% guarantee that it will do the same performance at the other location also. Means these machines are all depending on your soil and the crop, location specific, all these factors are there into that. If you can able to give as a location wise, what is the best operating conditions for that particular machine, that will be very useful for those farmers. And when we have started giving this training program online, actually, when we say as a farmer and entrepreneur, whether the farmer can able to access the internet, they are all illiterate, they are poor. This is the thing, right? Everybody will be having a mindset. Whether they can able to participate into the training program, that is why we have posted this one on YouTube Live also. Let it be either this, the information is passed either today or tomorrow. If some educated, at least the farmer, the kid or the son or daughter of the farmer who is literate, he can able to understand the information, and thereby they can guide their father or mother. With that, we can able to support little bit to the poor or whoever, the marginal or small farmers. That is our main aim. Hope that I think at least it is only the beginning. With all of your support, surely we will make our agriculture sector as a big sector in our country.
Sir, one issue with this big machines, combine harvesters, they are very big, large in size. And farms are very small, sir.
Yes.
Practically, it is impossible for this machine to go into the farm.
Yes.
So any smaller equipment available?
Sandeep, yes. For the small farms, there is like a vertical conveyor reaper. We can go with the small width of operation. Once we dry that one, we can go for the threshing operation also. Or as a thresher, the small units are available. The combine harvester, where we cannot able to handle very big land or as a marginal or large farm size, there we can go with the combine harvester. But the smaller thing, yes, the machine is very big and cost is also very high. The substitute is also available for these small farms. Like we can go with as a combine harvester and the vertical conveyor reaper, and we can thresh the thing also. And nowadays, even the small harvesters are also available, like the portable harvesters. Directly, we can hang as a operator and we can harvest the crop also, like as a manual weeders and all. The machines are also available. But yes, the performance is a factor. We need to keep that also into the mind.
Yes. Threshers are available, sir. Threshers come to the farm, come to the land.
Yeah, yeah.
On a tractor. And yes, we get it, get the crop done with this.
Yeah.
But harvesting is an issue. Harvesters are not that efficient.
Yes, yes.
Small harvesters, manual harvesters.
Again, it is a matter of initiation also. Once you initiate, na, others will get encouraged to get. Even if you are a marginal farmer, combiners are working here in Bihar. Even with the marginal farmers, as someone called the hired that combiner, and then it got so popular that everyone is willing to harvest their farm with the harvester only. And then they are collectively, they are calling them and they are doing the same work.
Yes, exactly. They are
once you will initiate, it will get popular in your locality and everyone will be able to do the same thing.
Yes.
And the combine harvester can run in a field which is plain.
Not
what about hilly region?
No, not hilly region. Exactly.
Our is a hilly terrain.
Yeah, yeah. And this, yeah, we have this.
And 5 gunta, 10 gunta, we have rice, patches of rice. Hilly terrain, they make level the land and they do rice paddy. So it's very difficult.
Yeah, any input from the other participants or any query?
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Yes. Sukanta.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Mr. Sukanta.
Hello. Hello, sir.
Yes, yes, please.
Sir, actually, I am from Tripura, sir. Actually, in this area, so maximum lands are, sir, actually dry lands and maximum lands we are planting like that for paddy cultivation. So actually for paddy harvesting, I have seen in like that Haryana, Punjab, the farmers are using at a time combined harvesting machines like that. They have to collect the paddy one side and the other paddy straws are other side. But in case of our state, so the problem is farmers in the land are maximum times water is collecting in the water is having in the soil field. So the farmers are not collecting proper the paddy and others. So if there is any kind of machine which can use farmer for separating the paddy and paddy straw, sir?
Which can be used paddy and paddy straw?
Paddy and paddy straw, yes, sir. So separately collecting. Yes, sir. Sir, in means there is the land is very soft and water is all time present in the land. So that's why the peoples are not collecting in separately. So the machines are not going inside the field. So is there is any kind of machine?
Yes, so machines are available. The track type machines are available. And even
I have been bell drive chain system is there for cutting the wood, soil. So is there is any kind of machine which can use for paddy harvesting, sir?
Yes, yes, machines are available, Mr. Sukanta Das, for paddy harvesting, even for the wet field condition also, the chain or track type machines are available. And nowadays,
is there any kind of company, so you can provide that company name, sir, it will be better for me, sir. Actually, I have also FPOs and I also have a farmers club. So I am the chief coordinator of that farmers club and also that the CEO of FPO, sir. So actually the farmers, so many problems are there. So they are asking for that kind of machine is available. So I want to contact that company. So sir, is there any company having, then just you send me the link, sir.
Sure, Mr. Sukanta Das, you can mail me the requirement of the whatever you want to level here related to the problem. Okay.
Okay, thank you, sir. I can give you my mail.
Yes, yes, yes. I'm just sharing the link. Just a minute, I got that. Yeah, today's session link.
Hello, sir. My only query is that by when is the institute opening for hands-on sessions or like demonstrations at the campus?
On-site training.
Okay.
Yeah, on-site training.
Yeah, we are waiting. Eagerly waiting.
Are you once the our institute starts allowing the participants from outside? Anyway, it is not like as a DC. Surely we will communicate with you and we will allow you to come over here and we will give you the hands-on training program, farm mechanization and composting, vermicomposting and all these, even greenhouse cultivation also is there over here. Well, surely we'll call you, but I cannot tell you exactly which time and all. Anyway, I'll communicate to all of you. I have your email IDs and all. Surely I'll give you the information.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. And related to the feedback form and all, I can share you the feedback form after this session. And wherever you have registered, you can again open the same link. There also I'm giving you the video link. And also, if you have not seen the previous videos, you can also go through that. And feedback form is also provided over its there itself. You can give your queries and feedback through that form.
Sir, I have sent you that my mail address, sir.
Yeah. Hello, sir. Yes, it's yeah, it is there. Okay, I have noted this one.
I just want to know if there is a food processing training session is also
is there
in your institute
training schedule? Yes, it is there.
And in this session is also that is there.
Yes, in the same in this December 2020 series it is there. It is on I think 14 or 15. It is there 16th and 17th. The session is there on food processing.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you all. You can just get
thank you, sir.
Yeah. I'll share you the link, the feedback link in the same registration form. There itself, we can get this link.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you all. Thank you.
Sir, the attendance link is also there.
Yes, sir. Attendance link is also there. In the Facebook page, we have just kept that one. The Facebook page also I can share you.
I was not aware, sir.
Yeah, oh, no, I'm sharing with you. Here you can get the videos as well as the feedback or attendance form link is also you can get at this particular the Facebook page. For the previous lectures also I have kept the feedback form over there. After going through that lectures you can fill this. Okay, thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.